Make one for every day of the week or evening outings or for work or for leisure for anything. Okay, this is fun to make and you can practice your single crochet, chain stitches, slip stitch with this fun project. For an average 5-inch phone, you need to make a chain the width of your phone, and I've noticed that you need 10 chain stitches. So make a slip knot. That's a slip knot. And make 10 chain stitches. Make sure your chain stitches are not too tight or too loose because you'll be working into them. Check to make sure that you've got the right size. So that's about right. And now you're going to go into each chain stitches. You're going to go into each chain stitches and make one single crochet. At the end of the row, you will have 9 single crochet because the first one will be your turning chain. That's one. Carry on working down. See you at the end. I have 9 single crochets. Hope you have 9 single crochets as well. So make a chain, a turning chain, and turn your work, and then you'll be working into each single crochet all the way around. This pattern is a beginner friendly and is very, very easy for anyone that has not done crocheting before. If you've learned the basic stitches, if you haven't, you can check in the description box below or on the screen you will see an icon. Just check the playlist for the appropriate stitches that you need to learn and then come back and make your first crochet project. Okay, with this pattern, all you need to do is to grow or crochet your rows of single crochet double the length of your mobile phone. With this 5-inch mobile phone, you need to make double this length because we'll be folding it over. So carry on. And I've noticed with this pattern that you need about 44 rows of single crochets. Now it depends on the kind of mobile phone you've got. It depends if you've attached a mobile phone case cover before you measure. So the choice is yours. But you need between about 40 to 44 rows of single crochets. I'll see you nearly at the end of your 44 rows of single crochet, and then we carry on to do the next step in
Okay,
this
to
project.
count your stitches as you go along, I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9, and I'll turn and carry again. Happy crocheting. See you soon, and good luck. Welcome back and well done. Now we've got 44 rows of single crochets. Now, depending on what rows you've got, check with your mobile phone to make sure that your rows of single crochets folds over your phone easily and meets at the other end. Like that. Don't worry about the sides yet. We're going to do that. That's what you need. Yeah. Okay. So that's fine. So we put our phone away. And what we need to do now, we need to make single crochets all the way round the entire length of our project. Okay, so the right way facing. Okay, and then I go into, this is the first corner. You have four corners. That's the first one, single crochet, and then I go back into the same space and then I make another single crochet. Okay, and then I walk down with the sides of your project or material. Make sure that you go into each, you will see two bar or two poles there. Go in there and then make a single crochet and carry on all the way down. When you get to the next corner, we'll meet up and I'll show you what to do. See you soon. Okay, nearly at the end, or the last one to go in the corner. What you need to do is you need to make three single crochets in the corners. When you get to the corners, you make three single crochets in the corner. Okay, that's one. Two and three. Okay, to save time, just walk over the tail. This is your beginning tail, you need to walk over it. So when you go into the next two bars, walk over your tail. Okay, you're hiding your tail as you go along. Now we are at the corner here, so you could go in there, but you don't want it to create a big hole, so just ease your way in there. Okay, and make three single crochets. When you make three single crochets, it helps to turn your work and it gives you a neat corner or neat edge, the edging. Okay, now what I want you to do now is to carry on walking down and then we meet up just there. Coming to the next corner. Okay, well done. Put three single crochets into this corner to turn your work, and then you work all the way down. Okay, now one more and then slip stitch into the corner. Okay, pull up and pull through. You have successfully made your panel. You have successfully made your panel. Now check it with your mobile phone again. Okay, make sure you can see that's the back and the other side is the front. That's it. Well done. Now what I want you to do now, you need to join
this top part. From this corner, you're going to work single crochet, sewing them together to this corner. I'll show you. This is going to be your right side. You can see how nice it's looking flat. And this is the wrong side. It looks a little bit bumpy. Yeah, the wrong side. Okay, carrying on, single crochet, you have 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, yarn over and pull through all the 4 loops. You have 2 loops now on your hook, yarn over and pull through 2, going to the next, that's 2, and then the next one, that's 2, yarn over, pull through, you have 2 loops, yarn over and pull through both loops. That is making is like you're sewing it with a single crochet. This project is very good for anyone to learn how to make their single crochets perfectly. And you need slip stitch and chain stitches as well, but more so your single crochets. Now you're coming to the corner. You need to go into the corner there. You have 4, if you can see. Okay, yarn over and pull through. Go again into the same space. Okay, and pull through. Yeah. Normally you put 3 single crochets in the corner, but for this project we're gonna be turning it inside out, so we don't want the corner to be too pointy. So only make 2 single crochets in that corner and then turn your work and carry on working. Just exactly as you did on top here. Carry on doing it. Okay, and I see you just nearly at the end of it and of this. There, somewhere there. And then I can show you what to do next. Well done, I'm very proud of you. Carry on. Okay, nearly at the end. Keep on making your single crochets to sew your phone cover or phone case together. Now, that is the last 2 single crochets that you need to sew together. So you go into there and pull through 2 loops on your hook and pull through. Okay, you have completed sewing it. So what you need to do is make 1 chain stitch, pull tight and cut. Okay. Alright, well done. Okay, you need to sew in your tail end. You can use a crochet hook or you can use a darning needle. I'll show you that later on. Okay, for now, just weave in your hands with your crochet hook, however you like. And then, see ya. When you weave in your hands, try to secure it tightly by making a knot. Okay, so it will last longer and will not unravel. Now cut. We've weaved in the tail so we can cut. Alright. Well done. We're nearly there. Now you've got something looking like this. Aren't you proud of what you've done? You need to turn inside out. I apologize for the noise. It's my neighbors doing their own thing. And I've got to get this done. Now you've got something looking lovely and like this. Don't forget, you can make this project in any color of your choice. This is an acrylic yarn. The other one I showed you earlier was made from acrylic yarn mixed with metallic yarn.
So use whatever yarn. This project is good for leftover yarns. Leftover. Yeah, this is how I want your phone case to look for now. So what you need to do is, we need to carry on with the next bit, okay? We need to make a flap to cover it. Alright. Now, get your crochet hook. Okay, you have your seam here on the inside, on the right side. So, look for the top of the next single crochet, the two bars or two loops next to the seam, and put your yarn through and pull through. Now you have your yarn tail and your yarn coming from your skein of yarn or your yarn ball. Okay, now pull the two through, all the way through till your tail comes out. Alright, now to secure, put the loop on the hook and then pull on both the working yarn and the tail, and that makes a knot for you. Okay, to secure it. Now you need to make a single crochet from the right side to the left side, the last single crochet that is close to your seam on the left side. Oh, you can see here on the left side. Okay, all right, let's go together. Okay, pull through two loops, yarn over, pull through, single crochet down, next. Okay, don't forget to walk over your tail. Well done, you're doing very well. This is the beginning of many projects to come. The more you practice, the better you become at crocheting. So once you finish this one, you can make another one, and you've got something to give your loved ones for Christmas, which is coming round the corner. Yay! Well done. If you start early, then you don't. If you start early, then you don't have to rush or worry later on. Okay, your yarn tail is gone. That's the inside, and that's the outside. Okay, see you nearly at the end. Welcome back, nearly at the end of our flap making. Okay, got one more there. Make sure you don't go through to the other side. You can put your hand inside to steady it. Okay, there you go. Check. What do you think? One more? Yes. One more. Single crochet, and then you check again. Okay, that's it. All right. So what you need to do is you need to turn your work. Okay, normally when you're turning work, you make a single chain, a turning chain, but with this project, don't make a chain, just turn and go into that single crochet space, pull through, yarn over, and just make your single crochet. This way your edging will be a lot neater and easier for you. Okay, now we walk all the way down to this single crochet. See you nearly at the end. Okay, nearly at the end there. Single crochet in there and go in to the last single crochet, pull through two loops, yarn over, pull through, turn your work, and then you carry on walking down. See you at the end. Now with the phone case, we're trying to make this flap. If you want, you can just leave yours without any flap. So if you see this one, you can, this type of material, you can take it out in the evening and no one will know you've got your mobile phone on it until it's ringing. Make four rows. We've done three so far, so one more to go, and then we make the button hole. Okay, with this is how the flap is looking at the moment. With my flap, I've got 22 single crochets on the top, so I'm going to single crochet into 9 stitches and then begin to make the flap for 2 single crochets. So this is how we do. Remember not to do a chain, a turning chain, because you want your edge to be neat and nice. Okay, so now go ahead and make, if you have exactly what I've got. If you don't, if yours doesn't count like mine, what you need to do is count the total single crochets that you have on your flap and then divide into 2, and then in the middle, because in the middle I'm putting 4 in the middle, and then you divide the other sides, if you get what I mean. So now I've got 8 single crochets on this side, and then I'm going to have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 there. So I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 to play with. So I need to make 6 single crochet, I need to make 6 chain stitches. 2, 4, 6. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, going to the 6th single crochet and make a single crochet. Now you are the designer, so you can adapt and make it according to the size of the button that you've got. I've got this fancy button and I'm going to make sure that it can pass through easily. So that is that. Okay, so that's good for me. If your button is a bit smaller, so you just make your space in between here maybe 4, you go into the 4th one, and then you make this side 9 and that side 9 single crochets. Hope you understand that. Okay, so now carry on the other side making your single crochets, and see you nearly at the end. Well done. Now we are at the other side. This is how your project should be looking like. Okay, this side should be looking. Now turn your work, and then you're going to make a single crochet all the way down. When you get to this place, I'll see you and then I'll show you what to do. I need to say that this project will be a walkover for any advanced crochet beginner or intermediate beginner. For any beginner out there, if there's any section that you have any query or you're not so sure about, leave a comment down below and we'll get back to you and show you how to do those areas. It's just we don't want this video to carry on for too long, so certain aspect we expect you to have grasped it and then, you know, carry on. That's why, you know, we try to cut some areas out of this project so it's not too long. Okay, now you've got a single crochet at the base of the chain stitches, so go in there, yarn over, pull through, make a single crochet. Okay, so now you work single crochets into each chain stitches. Work by picking up the back hump. When you do this, it gives you a neat effect, a neater edge. Got the first one, yeah, yarn over, pull through, yarn over, pull through, 2 loops, yarn over, pull through, single crochet. Go in there and then find your hump. Okay. Pull through.
Now carry on walking till you've made 6 single crochets. See you. Now this is how the top is gonna look like. Okay. The buttonhole. Alright, carry on to the end. So far, this is what we've done with the flap. Okay. Now, you could leave it this way if you want to, but I'll make a single crochet all the way down. Just make a single crochet on top. Don't worry about the buttonhole that you've got there. Just make your single crochet. Oh, sorry. Let's see. Okay. Pull through. Okay. Pull through. All the way to the end. Okay. Now what you need to do now is you need to make a chain, a single chain, and then cut your yarn off. Pull through to secure. Okay, now you've got a raw edge here and a raw edge here. So what you can do is you need to pick up in the corner through and secure pull bolt. Okay, secure. Walk over your tail and go back into the same space and make a single crochet with both the walking yarn and the yarn tail this time around. So you're weaving in your yarn tail as you go along, okay? And pull through the loops, okay? That's secure. That's a single crochet. Now go into this space here. Don't forget to walk over your tail. Make a single crochet. This way you have a much more professional edge and presentable edge. Alright. When you get to this corner, you make a single crochet in there. Make another single crochet and you make one more and walk all the way down. Okay, carry on. That's how the corner. Now we are this corner, so we're gonna make 3 single crochets to turn and then single crochets. Single crochet all the way down. Okay, when you get here, just go in there into the V stitch itself, because if you go into the space, it's gonna give a big hole, so you don't want it to be too gapy. Okay, all right.
and then single crochet all the way round till you get there. See you nearly at the end of that. Now you're getting to the end where you started from. Getting to where you started from, so don't go in there because that will give a big hole. So what you can do is just make a makeshift place and put it there. See, that closes the gap a little. Now this is where you started first, so go into that single crochet. You have two bars and this loop, pull through and pull through to slip stitch. Yay, cut, and then we should be almost there, or there if you want to stop now. Okay, now weaving your ends, you need to weave this in. Okay, pretend we've done that now. Yeah, weave that in. Okay, now you need a button. I've got this fancy one and I'm just gonna have it right there. Isn't that beautiful? The bling bling phone cover case, bling bling. Now you need to sew your button on. Okay, attach it. It's got a big hole, and then to sew my button on, I'm just gonna cut some, maybe that's better, is longer than what you need. Okay, yep, got the button you need and your knitter's needle. Okay, I use this big eye one. Okay, put it through, pass it through. Okay, pull through. All right, got my lovely phone case here. I need to cut the end of this one. That's your phone case. Okay, now I decide to put my button there. Just want to make sure that when I want to pass it through, it's gonna work. So that's about right. Okay, so now go to the back. All right, and just sew it in there to secure. Okay, you need to do that a couple of times and then weave it in through with your darning needle. Okay, and you weave it through. See you once that's, yeah, this is how it's looking now.
Make, yeah, one for every day of the week in there, the red multiple colors and the bling bling night one. Okay, it takes no time at all to make these fancy phone case cover. Make as many as you can with your scrap here and
and enjoy making them, and you can use them or give them as a gift. Hope you enjoyed making this fun, beginner-friendly project.
Thank you so much for letting me be a part of your crochet journey. Thanks for watching this tutorial. As always, we're glad to have you on Hands That Rock Crochet, where we put power in your hands. Don't forget to like, comment, rate, share this video, and subscribe to our channel if you like what you've seen. We wish you a great success in your crochet journey. Thank you and have a great day.